Welcome to Toffee Blue View, your source for all things Everton. I'm Gerry. Paul is back with a brand new invention. You like my vanilla ice there? We need to go over outgoing transfers. There have been some. We've had no incomings. They've been all outgoing. Let's cut the wage bill so we can bring in some people who aren't going to be stealing a living. That'd be great. Let's just start with one that people are sort of conflicted about. Wayne Rooney to DC United on a free. And that the reason it's on a free has to do with wages, I believe. Some people are annoyed that he left. Some people are like, oh, he's a legend. And other people are like, no, he's not an Everton legend. He gave us some goals last season. Cool. Have fun. Come back and coach sometime. That's, to me, seems like the natural way to put it. You know what I mean?
Regarding Wayne Rooney, I think the people who took it badly because it's very clear now, obviously, based on what he said at that press conference, that Rooney himself has taken it badly. I think if Rooney was kind of like the driving force behind the move, if Rooney had came out and said, no, I definitely want to go here. I don't want to stay at Everton anymore. MLS is absolutely where I want to be. Then I think kind of the supporters who wanted him to stay would not be kind of, they wouldn't be as vigorous in their defense of the guy. I mean, I've read a lot of people saying, oh, the guy still had it. He just needed legs around him. He was misused. He played too many games that the manager didn't use him properly. And there is some truth to that, maybe. But
yeah.
It was time to leave. It was the best deal for all parties. But I think the only people who've got a problem with it are the people who, you know, they love Rooney. It really hurt them when he left. And it's hurting them again that he's leaving again now. But the big difference this time is Rooney forced the move last time. It seems very much like it was the club forcing him to go this time, because he did not, to me, I mean, he was putting a brave face on it, but he did not look overly thrilled at being at that press conference yesterday. It seemed like, I'm only here because it's the next best thing, kind of thing. I didn't get what I want, so I'm just kind of trying to make the best of this, which is what I think, that was just all his body language told me in that press conference when I watched it was, I'm just going to try and make the best of this, see what happens. Not, yes, this is absolutely what I want. I'm going to really wrap my arms around this. Rooney, it was time to leave. Yeah. And I think the man himself is having a hard time accepting that.
Yeah, and I agree with that. I'm a sentimental guy. I don't like... I was psyched the fact that he came back. I thought he actually started the season much stronger than I expected. I think he's got some in the tank still. I do. I think he can still play. But the problem is we brought in a director of football and a manager. Okay? We brought them both in. Okay? We're showing faith in them. They have priority right now. The director of football's number one priority right now, cutting the wage bill to bring in other players. He's trying to be responsible. And if a player is not going to be contributing significantly, we're going to put them somewhere else to cut their wages. That's just what's going to happen. And I guarantee you, Rooney had a conversation with Silva, and Silva was like, I don't know what to tell you, man. You don't fit into my plan. You don't fit into my system. Because he doesn't. Look at his previous teams. Okay? He wants three center midfielders who have some pace and are going to run hard the whole time. You know what I mean? And that's the thing. And I don't think Rooney is going to cover as much ground as the other center mids. And I just don't think... I think he can contribute in DC. I think he'll do well, better than other people are predicting. But you just can't have room for sentimentality when you're trying to turn around a club right now. That sucks, but it's the reality. You know, you bring in people who can make hard decisions and take the friggin' emotion out of it. You know what I mean? So. But good luck, man. Wayne, I am going to be going to DC to watch you with my family. Just saying. I'm driving. It's happening. And it'll be a big deal. A really big deal. Luke Garbutt to Oxford United on loan. The reason it's a loan is because we gave him a new contract. So that's... No one's going to buy him for what we would need based on that contract. It's just not going to happen. So he's on loan. Our loan players usually do well at Oxford. They're usually happy. So hope he does well. You know? It's just a disappointing situation. I think all of us were hoping he'd get more of a shot last season rather than Cuco Martina at left back, which was not a natural fit. So Connor Grant to Plymouth Argyle, he wasn't probably going to play. You know, good luck, man. I think that was a permanent, by the way.
Yeah, local kids, good. They can't all make it. That's just the reality of the situation. Doesn't mean they can't go and have a decent career and make some money and be proud of themselves, but just not every kid who dreams of pulling on the boots and putting on the jersey for Everton is capable of achieving their dreams at that level, at least. So, as you said, it's just the reality of football. There's only so many dreams that can be fulfilled.
And every time I saw him play, there was some promise there. But I mean, I think he plays at a position where you need either more speed or more size. You know what I mean? And that's something that I don't know that he seems like he's lacking a bit of that. So, yeah, hope he kicks ass, though. Robles is gone.
I've personally got a lot of time for Robles. I mean, he had his chances to seize the number one spot for himself, and he just never quite managed it. I mean, he would have a run of good games, but then in a vital game, he'd let himself down. It's hard to really dig at the guy because I think the good outweighed the bad with Robles. He did far more things that impressed me than things that really made me just get annoyed at him. But you know, when you've got Jordan Pickford, you haven't got a prayer of dislodging the guy. I would really like Robles if he could stay. I think he was a good goalkeeper. He would be a great backup, but I don't begrudge the guy going somewhere to be number one. Good luck to you, Joel.
David Hinnan, the guy we thought was coming in at the time, the most bizarre transfer like saga with Olympiacos and Anderlecht. Yeah. It was just the weirdest combination. He's leaving. I think when Martinez brought him in, we were all expecting him to make an impact quickly.
Yeah.
You know, young Belgian, is he a striker? He's a winger, whatever. He's quick, he's fast, he's got speed. It's a bummer because I was always hoping he would get a chance this year too.
Yeah.
I was hoping he was going to... Yeah.
Strange player. Been here for a while. Big things were touted originally and just for whatever reason, it never happened. Yeah. I mean, he went out on loan. Did he go out? You think he went out on loan a couple of times?
He did.
And just
never
pulled up any tree. So maybe the guy is just not that good and it's just another stinker from Roberto Martinez.
It's hard to say.
To go with his many other stinker players. I mean, Martinez could make my grandma sound like Pele, where you would wax lyrical about them. So, he was brought in when the love for Martinez was at its all-time peak, so people believed every word out the guy's mouth when he was waxing lyrical about this kid. But, you know, as I said, just a lot of young players show promise, and then it just never materializes. So, again, good luck to the guy, but there was that feeling of, when he got here, right, I can't wait to see what this kid's made of. It's disappointing that we never really saw anything.
Yeah.
So I don't think he did. Did he ever play a Premier League game for Everton at any point?
No.
It tells Gerry, doesn't it? So,
yeah, Martinez missed his calling as a salesman. I'm telling you, the guy can sell anybody anything. Just saying. But David Hinnan, again, good luck, man. He seemed like he wanted to play for Everton. Just saying. Speaking of someone who didn't really seem like they wanted to play for Everton at the end, Funes Mori to Villarreal for around £9 million. That 20-something million was not accurate, apparently. I get the vibe the reason this happened so early is because he was pushing for it hard, that he just didn't want to be here anymore. That leaves us with no left-sided center back, no left-footed center back on the squad. So is this a smart transfer? I mean, it seemed triggered by Funes Mori. Assuming we've got people lined up, it seems like it was a good idea, right?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, Funes Mori had a lot of guys, a lot of supporters who did like him. I mean, he was all heart. I'll give the guy that. The guy, you know, it seemed like every time he went on the pitch, he did give it his all.
Yeah.
And he did score some memorable goals. And it looked like it did mean a lot to him, getting the fans on side. I mean, but you know, he just was not reliable enough. It's the fact of the matter. There were too many instances where he made the wrong decision or just didn't have enough common sense. Now, if it was a case of sell Funes Mori and bring through a kid and try to replace him, then no, I would not be happy. I would like, no, if we can't go out and buy a ready-made replacement, then don't sell him. But it seems very likely that a new centre back is going to come into the club. So yeah. If that's the case, shake hands to Funes Mori. You know, there were some good times here. You're welcome to come back anytime you like as a supporter or anything like that. But just go and live out the rest of your career now. So it's a good business, especially considering the fact we made a profit.
Yeah.
That whatever that money is, it seems that we have managed to make money on our initial investments, which, considering the fact that he didn't have an awful lot of good games when he played for us, that's hard to do nowadays, to make profits on players who don't really impress anybody. Really, when a player comes here and he kind of doesn't ever establish himself at any club, it's hard to make a substantial profit on them. You normally just have to sell them for cheap to get them off the wage bill, but it seems like we've made quite a bit of money, so good luck to the guy. He's back in a league. He'll go to a league now that suits him better. They'll speak his native language because he's a Spanish speaker at first. So good luck to the guy. I won't miss him an awful lot personally, but yeah, what else is there to say? We can do better than Funes Mori. That's top and bottom. The club can do better than Funes Mori, and it looks like they are going to go out and do better than Funes Mori.
Yeah, I think we paid about the same amount that we got paid. You know what I mean? Mm. I think we bought him for around $9 million.
$9 million.
And I think we just brought in around $9 million. So I think it was about the same. I think we kind of broke even with Funes Mori. But getting money, period, is a good thing. And his wages are something to be keep in mind too.
Yeah.
Funes Mori was always good for about one brain fart a game. And that's scary when you play center back. Just saying. I think that's it right now for outgoing transfers.
Yeah.
Are we missing someone? Clausen.
Ashley Williams. Yeah. Ashley Williams to Stoke.
Yeah, that one might happen. Klaassen to Besiktas might happen. He's been rumored as being a part of a Domagoj Vida deal, but the terms of that change every day in the Turkish media. Who knows? I heard with the Stoke transfer, it's all about wages. That would be holding him back on that. Schneiderlin to Marseille, but as you mentioned in previous videos, Silva supposedly has tried to talk Schneiderlin into staying. So there's that. And who knows what Morales is doing? Who knows?
Cleaning the toilets.
No idea. There's also
that's all.
There's also rumors of DCL to Sheffield United on loan for a season. I don't know. There was a rumor. Just saying. So that's it for outgoings right now that I can think of. All right.
Yeah.
If you're digging the videos, please subscribe. We're sitting around 860, so we'd appreciate it if you help us climb. Take some time. Check out the Toffee Blues website. Paul's got some stories there, as do some of our other friends, like Max and Tom and Thomas and lots of people dropping stories on there, okay? Good analysis. Check them out, all right? One more to do, Paul. Let's get on this. Ready?
One more.
All right.
Yep.
All right. Bye.